Okay, now I'm applying the last wax after the dark wash added here. I need to seal that with additional wax. But this time I want to make sure all the surfaces are covered, leaving no breaks. So my brush could be bigger, I think. Let me put more wax on the skillet so it will not run out. Paint much here, but still there are some maybe areas I want to. Especially these dark areas that was missed was the first one. I want to get some more wax in and some white area also maybe. It should be completely waxed at this point. What I'm thinking now is that when I lift the wax with newspaper, I may put a waxed painting first and just let that painting absorb the wax. And then we will try to see if we can make cracks or something instead of wax, waste all the wax on the newspaper. I will use a painting close to the original, this painting, so the wax will go onto that blotting painting, so to speak. So I don't mind at this point to get lots of wax on it, so my experimenting painting will get it anyway, so I'm not wasting it. I don't feel bad about that. So just put a lot of wax, a lot of wax, completely cover the whole painting. I think now it's maybe too much, but I like it. I think that would be the idea. So let me get a painting for what I'm going to do. Let me just put this wax there. Let me turn off this skillet. I should exhaust this brush, otherwise it will not easy to melt. So I just take a paper towel and dry the remaining. You see this wax on the handle? That's it. That's okay. Residual on the. Maybe turn off the skillet. Oops, I touched the screen. Accident. Okay, here's another version of this, the same project I did. So this one is on a different paper. It's a semi-sized Schwann paper. So I'll put this on the same, so the color scheme would be exactly the same. Anyway, you won't get any color, just the wax, I think. So maybe I'll just, yeah, this, there's no back side or wrong sides. I'll do another one with the rolls, so hopefully they will not stick on the this not stick, I think. When it's wet, it should be fine, I think. So this is the first two layers. I'll add some newspaper still. Let me see, where's my, okay, here. Yeah, normally we use 4 layers or 5. newspaper, a newsprint. I'll put a lot more on the bottom this time, so I don't have to change it. Okay. And there's some on top. Okay. I need the iron. I use this as different iron than the dry mounting iron. Just make sure they are not interfere with each other. So the stains on this one or on that one will not create problems. Now I'm ready to iron. It will be set on cotton. It's already there, I think. So we just start from the center. It will take a while to iron out the wax completely, but it will be fun because I put my paintings close to the waxed painting, so you will get wax on it. I may be able to recycle it. Well, I hope not the newsprint. Anyway, it's already there. So let's just see. It's not. I won't worry about that painting because it's a abandoned painting. We may apply more wax if not enough from this blotting. Look at the nice pattern on it, I think. I don't think you need to press that hard. It's not mounting, so I just kind of gliding on it slowly. Actually, wait, I mean, melt the wax. You can see the wax will melt when it's hot, right? And when it's cooled down, it will become solid. And you can see the wax coming through there. Now you can replace the top layers frequently and just leave that painting, I mean the first layer there. This is also a preserve, you might call it wax mounting. Wax is a good preservative. It will not only make the painting smooth, wrinkle free, also preserve it for at least 1 century, I think. So you will not need to remove all the wax, but maybe 99%, something like that, 90%. See this wax coming through, that's a lot. I think that they're not even, so this part may be less. I put a metal board on the bottom that reflects the heat, I think. test the first layers, see what happens here. Where's my painting? Okay, let me set my iron here. I have to remove this layer. Oh, nice. This is the blotting painting. It got wax on it. But, they're sticking together. That's the problem. I was a little concerned because you don't want to wait it too cool because this two layer may stick together. It's like adhesive. So you need to keep it warm when you separate them. When it's still warm. Okay. That's too risky, I think. Don't do this. Unless this painting is strong, like a mulberry paper. This strong paper won't work, because it might tear. Just melt it. But it might do the opposite. Okay, I think that helps. Just melt it. Yeah. So that's okay. This is I will save it for next project. So let's move the bottom one as well. Now that's easier. This one also got wax texture on it. So when I wash background, you will see the resist effect, I think. So let's keep using the newspaper just for blotting purpose. I opened the window so the smoke will not accumulate here. You need to blot this iron until there's no wax coming out from the original painting to the newspaper. Then you know you're done. Okay, almost done. You can see there's no more wax. Just a little bit penetrates through. The only two layers newspaper I'm not using. Three layers. See, this one still got a little bit wax. And this should be fine now, I think. We could remove the newspaper and show you the result. Okay, now you can still paint on it, if you will, to add more color. Need it, you can use gouache or use dark to cover the white spot. Let it dry and then we'll see. Actually, I could have signed before because after wax, it's kind of difficult to write. Signature, you can use marker pen maybe, if that's easier. Okay, I'll take some good pictures to show you.